Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Very good morning to all of you. His Excellency Frank La Rue, Assistant Director General for Communication and Information, UNESCO. His Excellency Mr. Wong Tam, Deputy Secretary General of ASEAN for ASEAN Social Culture Community. We just met recently. In March during the social culture community meeting in Iloilo, Philippines. Professor Shahbaz Khan, Director and Representative UNESCO Office, Jakarta. Excellencies, distinguished delegate, ladies and gentlemen. Let me begin by conveying the humble apology from Yang Bahagia Datuk Haji Abu Ghaffar bin H. Hamby, the Secretary General of the Ministry of Tourism and Culture, who is unable to be with us today due to an important meeting overseas which needs his presence. Yang Bahagia Datuk convey his best wishes to all the participants of the symposium. Therefore, I will read his speech on his behalf. It is indeed a great honor for me to be here today at the International Symposium on Preservation and Access, UNESCO's Memory of the World Program Team, Southeast Asia Documentary Heritage in the Digital Age. I would like to wish Selamat Datang to all the participants, as well as to our distinguished guests and speakers. To our foreign delegates, I hope that you will have the opportunity to experience Malaysia and all its flavor through to our tagline, Malaysia Truly Asia, during your stay here. Distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, I would like also to convey, thank you, and also express our gratitude, to UNESCO for having your symposium here in Malaysia. This is such a great honor for Malaysia as a host country to host this very important symposium this morning. The organization of the symposium is indeed timely as it aimed to develop a create action plan to address ongoing challenges relating to documentary heritage in the region through the implementations of the UNESCO recommendation concerning the preservation of and access to documentary heritage, including in the digital form. When you talk about preservation and history, I think it's very important, as I mentioned also to some of you this morning during our coffee, breakfast, And for example, like this place where you are sitting this morning is actually the first parliament in Malaysia. It's already converted into this auditorium. But I think history is still history. So that what you can get, it is from archive of Malaysia. So it's very important, all the history of this place to be stored as in digital form so that all our youngsters or a new generation knows this place is actually the first parliament in Malaysia through history, through digital form. Although you come here, this is already auditorium, but sometimes nobody knows this place is actually the first parliament in Malaysia. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, given the recommendation is relatively new and has yet to be applied to the region, the ASEAN plus three member state and its stakeholder will definitely need UNESCO support and guide in adapting this new instrument. We hope that the tailor-made event, specifically to the needs of ASEAN member state, which bring together experts, policymakers, and representatives from archive, museum, and also library from ASEAN, China, Japan, Korea, Timor-Leste, we'll be able to develop an implementation action for the recommendation toward the end of the event. And Malaysia, as the host country, is looking forward to the outcomes of the document. I understand the UNESCO is in the midst of developing a guideline for the implementation of the recommendation. I'm also happy to share some Malaysia initiative in preservation and access of documentary heritage. In this regard, the National Archive Malaysia has also developed several guidelines and recommendations, among others, electronic record management system compliance tests and evaluation process and procedures version 1.2009, and guideline to preserve and conserve public sector email 2010. Congratulations to National Archive of Malaysia. The Director General of the Archive is here today. Mr. Azmi, can you stand up, Mr. Azmi, so that everybody knows you? Yeah. In addition, Malaysia also organized a seminar under the Malaysia Technical Cooperation Program, or MTCP, on digital preservation as to increase understanding and awareness on the digital preservation. Another great initiative that I want to share is the National Archive System, known as Online Finding Aids, where Malaysia list of digitized material can be opened and accessed from anywhere in the world. So this is very important, yeah, for you to know about preservation and also about information, yeah, regarding Malaysia, because Malaysia has come up with this. So very importantly, I notice here some of you, I think a few of you, yeah, several of you, actually from the Malaysia Tourist Guide Council, headed by Diana there. And you know, this is very important for tourist guide. If tourists come to Malaysia, they want to know about history of Malaysia, they can go to archive, then they also can get the information online. So that's very important for them to tell to the tourists, because you know, last year, Malaysia received 26.7 million international tourists to come to Malaysia. Definitely, I think more than half of them, they want to know about history of Malaysia. So that's why very important for tourist guide here, Diana, headed by you, and also I saw just now, forgot the name, the lady who organized the heritage tour. Jane Rai, where's Jane Rai? Can I see Jane Rai at the back there? Because she's very dedicated, organized the heritage tour in Kuala Lumpur, walking tour. Yeah, so that I think you have to tell also your colleague, you know, among the tourist guide, to know more on our heritage through, you know, the online digital information from archive. This is very important for you. However, there are still some challenges that we need to address. Yeah? We do acknowledge the fact that this region is lacking in terms of expertise in handling digital records. Yeah? So this is why the symposium is done, to share knowledge and experience among all ASEAN member states. All 10 ASEAN member states are here today, and also plus Timor-Leste. Can I see the Timor-Leste representative? Anyone? Okay, thank you so much. Yeah? Thank you so much, because you're not the ASEAN member yet, so but we are welcome you. And also we have plus three. Plus three means from China, from Japan, and also from Korea. Yeah? And definitely we have from UNESCO, you know, to share experience, because this region still lacking in digital record. I think that's why this symposium is very important for us to share experience and expertise to address the issue. Distinguished delegate, ladies and gentlemen, It is my sincere hope that UNESCO's recommendation can further assist Malaysia as well as the other member state, both at national level through identification of documentary heritage strategies and policy measure ensuring preservation of an access to it, and at international scales through bilateral or multilateral research project and publishing guidelines, policies, and best practices models. Therefore, this symposium could be a good avenue for expert policymakers and representatives from the memory institutions to share experience, ideas, identify challenges and opportunities to develop an outcome documentary heritage document from society at large. This symposium could provide an avenue for exchange of view to promote greater cooperation among members. With great honor, I would like to formally declare the opening of the International Symposium on Preservation and Access, Southeast Asia Documentary Heritage in the Digital Age. With that, thank you so much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Your Excellency.